So you want to win an NCAA championship. Some think it's easy, and on paper, maybe it is. Just win the next six games in a row, and you've reached your goal. But as Dickie B is going to tell you, these are the toughest six games to play. And you'll see that in today's game between the Eastern Washington Eagles and the Seton Hall Pirates.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Pirates should be able to play a lot of bodies tonight, Dick, as they're highly favored on paper. But what are the keys for them to win?
Tonight, the keys are pretty simple. First, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Secondly, take care of the rock. No turnovers, baby. Turnovers only lead to easy scores the other way. And lastly, you got to pound the board. Boards lead to wins, baby.
Well, Dick, let's get this one started and see what happens. Job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in a basketball.
The power forward gets the ball. Steals the ball. They go into the low block. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
Applying great pressure defense. Went for the steal, but he wound up with a personal foul instead.
You see, that's what happens when you go for the steal. You end up with unnecessary personal fouls.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say?
Number 14, pump fakes. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The center takes the feed. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They'll work it around the arc. Number 34 with the ball. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Down inside. He fakes the shot. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
He looks at the hoop. Dickie's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups.
Nice fake.
That one's blocked from behind.
Great rotation by the D. I love it.
He keeps his dribble as they reset. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got it on the low block. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Unloads a three. There was no doubt about that one. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. Up fake. And up. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's obviously carrying his team, Brad. His teammates need to follow his lead and join in on the action.
He's going nowhere. Ball stolen. It's going the other way. That's where it's going.
Turnover city, baby. Gonna eliminate those turnovers.
Number one gets the pass. Way off target. Number 15 takes the pass.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box. Great pressure, great double team. Really explosive.
Number five is whistled for the foul. First personal foul. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
Thanks, Erin. Misses the second shot. Now trying to feed the low block. He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats it to the spot.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
What a silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Trying to feed the low block. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
Looking for contact. Drops the bucket despite the harm. With the fake.
Double team now, bad angle.
He looks for three, scorches the net. With a stop here, there will be sheer pandemonium in the stand. That was like a NASCAR wreck and no whistle.
Wow, no call. You like that NASCAR. Hey, where's Mr. Petty?
And a momentary look from three-point land. There's a double team waiting there. There's the fake. The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off. And I think right now, got to focus defensively.
Ball was loose, but the offense got it back. He fires it up. Off the rim and no good. Contact on the shot attempt causes the misfire. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing them to make that turn. I didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position. And then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking a shot when you make that turn. Up and inside.
Looking for a good shot. Got an open look if he wants it. He wants a three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Well, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Side for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
We get another look at it in the lane. On the dribble, gives it up. There they come with a double team to stop it. Another turnover.
I'm not talking apple turnovers either.
Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Jumps in. Too much contact there. It knocked him off balance a little. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Pressure that basketball. Help one another. Communicate.
Puts it up, looking for contact. They work the perimeter. Takes the shot. Way off target.
They strip him in a basketball. Got a little too fancy. Too much mustard there.
Looking for a good shot. There's the pick. There's the roll. Number 15 is emotionally pumped up.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. From the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Let's see if they go 2-for-1 here, Dick. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
They'll work it around the arc.
Up and inside.
Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the blocked shot.
He gets that one to fall.
We'll get a better look on the replay.
Shot clock is dead. Gave it up. He's got some room. Gets the rejection. On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket. Perfectly executed.
Check him out, Brad.
He just heaves it up there. Misses from downtown. At the end of the first half, the Eagles are up by 4. Well, Dick, so far we've got a close one. Any play that sticks out to you as the highlight of the half?
No bigger shot in the first half for me than this three ball from downtown, baby. Teams build the confidence they need when the threes are falling.
Well, it looks like the teams are just about set for the second half. Let's get back to the action. Seton Hall just couldn't seem to stop turning the ball over in that first half, Dick.
Hey, if you ask me, these guys haven't clued on the magnitude of this game yet. They need to take care of the ball from here on in, or they have no shot, and they'll be running lots of laps tomorrow in practice.
Dick, these kids have battled through a first half. They battled through an entire season and their conference tournaments, and now it's down to who's got some gas left in the tank.
Survive in advance, baby. Be able to move on. Because remember this, if you go to the loser's locker room, you're taking off the uniform for the last time.
He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on the defense to beat him to the spot, Mr. Nessler. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. What's even more important, they'll have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Whoa, not a good decision to take that shot.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nessler. Horrible shot selection.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Goes up for 2.
I love the sky hook, especially when you get great post position on the interior.
Working it around the perimeter. In the paint. Number 1 makes a great move to draw the foul. He goes to the free throw line. First one is good. Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major. Good defensive pressure. Head right on a ball, drive him to the spot you'd like to take him and then beat him.
And the ball goes out of bounds. Nick, how's that backcourt comparison shaping up, Ethan?
Hey, Brad, that's a question that these coaches should be asking themselves. How can they, as coaches, get the most out of their guards? Are they quick enough to pressure the opponent, or offensively, can they create off the dribble? To me, it's about finding the weaknesses and attacking them. Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
As one of the better players on the team's roster, he's expected to make big plays, isn't he, Dick?
He's what I like to call a surf and turfer, a superstar. Only the special ones get to this level.
They work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet. Fading away, impossible to block.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dumps it in. Looking for a screen on top and got it.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block, Dick.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that block shot.
And they come up with a steal.
He telegraphed that pass. Look at that try.
There, that's more like my stuff.
Wow. Little Barishnikov right there. You always were a dancer. Double team now, bad angle.
Points off turnovers, Dick, a stat I know coaches pay a lot of attention to.
Hey, Brad, it sure is. You want to limit your opponent's number of points off turnovers. Ultimately, you want to nullify the easy basket.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression. Frustration right there.
A high screen. Cross court. For the bucket. He seems determined to take the tough shot.
But they're not falling, and the offense is being totally taken out of sync.
Sets a screen for his teammate. Moving it around the perimeter. Takes the pass in the paint. For the deuce. That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot.
Got to get that ball movement. Get that good spacing.
Pump fakes. There's a double team waiting there. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Working around the perimeter.
Step out on that screener.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Contact causes the shot to come off. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing them to make that turn.
Gives it up. Nice move with a face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad, I like guys that
blocks the shot.
Oh my goodness, that was unbelievable, baby.
The fake. Got a nice screen. He shoots from right of the circle.
I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his board. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Picks off the lazy pass. The power forward handles the pass. Tries the turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move. Coming inside.
From way outside. Way off target. There's been nearly perfect defense so far out there tonight, Dick.
I can't imagine any complaints from the coaching staff.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. He dials long distance, rims out. He comes away with it. Looking for a good shot. Gave it up. And now with a power move on the inside.
Did a great job protecting the basketball, seals the defense off, and explodes to the basket.
He wants the crowd to get pumped up, Dick. He is feeling it.
He's saying, show me some love. I'm working my tail off here.
With the free throw. First one is good. Second shot, no good. Spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Fake. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. On the outside. On the outside. He shoots from the top of the key. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
The power forward handles the feed. Fakes it. Here's a double team. For two.
I love the sky hook. You cannot block that shot. He gets that ball in deep. Hey, Brad, why don't more guys use it?
The Eagles have a mismatch in the post.
You're right, Brad. There is a mismatch. There's the trap.
Takes it off him. On the dribble, gives it up. Fakes a jumper. Jump hook from the low post.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented blocks that they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Post screen.
Goes up for two. Can't get the shot to go. Timeout. They want to talk it over right here. And with that timeout, we go to the third member of our broadcast team. Aaron?
Well, guys, I'm sure the coaches are using this time to go over crucial end-of-game strategy. Now, often teams will dedicate parts of their practice to special situations and end-of-game strategy. Now's the time when that practice will pay off, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. I wouldn't mind seeing him change things up a little bit, Dick, here.
I wouldn't be surprised either.
Didn't give it to him down low. Going the other way. Takes away the pass. The small forward takes the pass. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
For the bucket. Easy one.
Timeout, George. Hey, can we get a drum roll, Mr. Nestler? This one's going down to the last ticks, baby.
Something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. He gives him the fake. He shoots from the angle.
They have to foul to send them to the line and hope they miss.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
And the clock stopped with a foul.
Brad, I think he'll continue to do so in an attempt to get back in the ballgame. They should look to foul the opponent's weakest free throw shooter.
And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Foul, and that stops the clock again. He goes to the line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. Second one, no good. He pulls down the rebound. The center gets the ball.
If they can get off some good shots and easy buckets, it might turn around this awful stretch of shooting for them, Brad.
Easier said than done, though, right now, Dick. He is going to the line. Sinks it. Misses the second. And the free throw woes continue.
This is embarrassing display of free throw shooting, Brad.
Play about ready to resume. Steals the pass. And the clock stopped with a foul. Turnovers, Dick, they just kill you every time.
I'll tell you, Brad, they sure do. You must keep the number to a minimum in order to maximize your number of shot attempts.
He makes the front end of the 1-1. Makes the second. They want to talk about it right here, Dick.
They got to find a way to chip it with his lead before it's too late.
Maybe some game plan changes, Dick?
You never know what's coming, Brad.
This is the big time. Not a whole lot of luck getting the baskets to fall lately, Dick.
They definitely aren't getting the bounces right now.
Well, Dick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going up.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
Eastern Washington came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nestler.